Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to The Breakdown. So on this episode of The Breakdown, I wanted to be a little more personal with you guys. With this new year, I made a goal. I wanted to lose some weight. I did it. My name's Jake. I lost 25 pounds, and it was super easy. It wasn't expensive, and my performance has increased. I can hike farther. I just feel so much better about myself. And it really wasn't that hard. So today, I want to share with you 5 simple, easy tips to help you lose weight like me. And I'm going to show you how to go from this to this. So, really easy. Maybe that wasn't what you were expecting. No, I know for a lot of people when they go backpacking, they're like, oh, my pack is so heavy. I feel like I've got to carry all of these things. I don't want to sacrifice comfort for weight. And that is true. When you go ultralight, you are going to have to sometimes sacrifice a few things in order to get your pack even lighter. But guess what? If you can do it, it's not going to be such a big sacrifice. You're going to feel better about yourself. You're going to hike farther. And it's going to be a lot more enjoyable in the outdoors. So like I said, 5 simple things that you can do to help save some weight. So the first thing, like I showed you, my old pack was a Kelty Pawnee. And it was a great pack. Super durable. Never had any issues with it. Lifetime warranty. I stand by Kelty's products. They're amazing. But my pack was a lot bigger than what I needed it to be. And when I bought that pack, I was actually cutting down on a lot because it didn't have a lot of pockets. And I tend to overpack. If there's a pocket, I am totally jamming something in there. But again, if you've got that extra space, you feel like you've got to pack more and it weighs down your pack, which really sucks. So my latest pack, when I bought my Geiger rig, cut down by quite a bit of space. But guess what? Even though I cut down on space, I'm still able to take everything that I need to take with me. I just had to learn how to live a little bit lighter. So that's number one, cut down on your pack size. I realize if you're going on a super long trip, you may have a tendency to say, okay, I need a super big pack. I got to pack a change of clothes for every day. I got to do all these things. Well, that's not necessarily true. Cut down on your pack size. That'll help you save some weight. Number two, this right here is my two-man backpacking tent. It really isn't that heavy, but guess what? It's bulky, it takes up a lot of space, and even though it's not really that heavy, my Grand Trunk Ultralight Hammock is like a quarter of that weight, if not less. So again, learn how to sleep in a hammock. It's really comfortable, it's really enjoyable, it feels great after a long day of hiking to be able to just climb in your hammock and swing. Again, there's plenty of ways and other tips like we talked about in our hammock camping video that you can stay warm while you're in a hammock as well. But yeah, you know, cut down on your shelter or build a shelter out of natural resources. Again, hammock, great way to go, super comfortable, super lightweight. So that's number two. Number three, water. I realize that everybody has to take water with them. But something that I've learned is if I'm going in a place where I know I'm gonna have water, I don't have to carry as much water with me. I know I used to take like 3, 4, 5 liters of water with me to get by for a weekend, and yeah, I could do that, but a lot of the times there was a stream nearby. There was some sort of water, whether it was spring, river, lake, that I could use, and I just wasn't doing it. So what I did is I went out and purchased myself a water filter. This one here is the Katadyn Hiker, and that one's been awesome, but there are even more ways that you can go without water and go without a filter. You can get some iodine tablets. You could get a SteriPEN, a UV filter. So again, there's plenty of ways that you can go from carrying a lot of water with you, which everyone knows is probably going to be the heaviest thing in your pack, and save some space as well. So iodine tablets, water filter, something like that. If you know you're gonna go in a place where there's plenty of water, don't feel like you have to carry it all on your back. Okay, the next one is your cooking system. So again, I'm a big believer and lover in the jet boil. That's been awesome for me. I love that everything is self-contained inside my container, but it's really heavy. And again, while it's great because it heats everything up super quick and I get to enjoy a lot of great, you know, freeze-dried meals, you know, it's heavy. So instead, Why don't you go and make yourself a little alcohol stove? This one here was made out of an aluminum can, and it works great. In one of our upcoming videos, we'll show you how to use it. And you can look, and there's plenty of places online that show you how to build one of these. And again, all it costs is an aluminum can. Now, you will have to carry some alcohol with you in order to cook with it and to burn. But again, this is going to save you so much weight in your pack. Maybe take a little bit more time to cook your meals, but again, you're saving on weight. So that's awesome. The last thing that I wanted to share with you on how to save some pounds is to use items that are multifunctional. So, as you guys know, if you followed our channel, we are huge buff people. We love our buffs. So, again, if you can find yourself some buff headwear, multi-purpose headwear like this, I can turn this into a beanie, a balaclava, wear it as a wristband, I could use it as a bandage, all sorts of ways to wear this thing. It's super light, it can keep me warm when I'm cold, keep me cool when I'm hot. That's awesome. Another thing that, you know, we just can't tell you enough about how much I love my Nixon Baja watch. With this particular watch, I've got my compass, I've got my thermometer, and I've got my flashlight. So while that may not seem like things that are very heavy, that's also going to cut down on my weight, because that's essentially three things out of my pack and something that's on my wrist that I would already have with me anyway. So again, go ahead and look into getting yourself a watch with multiple functions, different abilities that could save you some extra space in your pack. And once again, you know, having a flashlight on my wrist is always a good thing. So anyway, that's it. Five simple tips to help you with weight loss this year. Give it a try. If you have any other suggestions, feel free to leave a comment below. Thank you guys for subscribing, for watching, and as always, we will see you on the trail. Have a good one.